One of the best-selling games in the history of games is Minecraft, and it hasn't slowed down a bit since it really took off around 2012. But like most things of this size, there's probably plenty of things that I'm hoping you guys didn't already know about it. Regardless of how many hundreds of hours that you or friends may have put into it already, we're going to try to dig a little deeper. What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to the Facts Series. And today, we're going to be learning some new things about one of the biggest games ever made. That's right, Minecraft. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. First things first, let's talk a little bit about how Minecraft actually came to be. After all, it's a pretty unique concept for it to just appear, right? Minecraft was created by Marcus Persson, better known as his on-screen alias Notch. After putting plenty of time into games like Dungeon Keeper, Dwarf Fortress, and Infaminer, he was inspired to create a game of his own that would take elements from all three of those games and make something new. In fact, the whole idea for Minecraft's signature blocky visual style came from Infaminer, which was an early example of an open-source sandbox game. Now, originally, he conceived Minecraft as more of an RPG than an open sandbox game, but as things went on, he started to move away from the more structured format, and eventually the game would contain the openness that it is now known for. He also didn't intend for the game to be released to the public, as it was originally just a personal project for him, but after a while, he felt it was good enough for other people to appreciate his work as well, leading him to putting it out for everyone to try. Let's talk a little bit more about Notch since he was, well, the creator of it, right? He was born in Stockholm, Sweden on June 1st of 1979. When he was only 7 years old, he started learning computer programming on a Commodore 128 home PC, and just 1 year later, he programmed his very first video game at the ripe age of 8. You heard me right. He was 8 years old. He got his first job in the gaming industry in 2005 at age 26 as a developer for King, which is a studio known for their mobile games like Candy Crush Saga and Bubble Witch Saga. He then left that company in 2009 and started working with Jalbum, an online file sharing program. But he didn't stay there very long either. He wanted to focus more on personal projects and also work on another game called Worm Online, which was an indie MMORPG that officially launched in December of 2012. Throughout all of this, he was slowly working on his own game, which would eventually become Minecraft. So on May 17th of 2009, the first version of Minecraft was released via the TIG Source forums. This version was very, very basic, and it was later officially named the classic version of the game. For the following year, Notch continued to update the game with new content, modes, items, and adjustments to the physics. After about a year and a half, Notch realized that Minecraft may end up being something big, and he wouldn't be able to handle it all alone, so he pulled together all the money he had earned so far, and he started his own development team called Mojang. That's right. Minecraft eventually entered the beta phase on December 20th of 2010, during which time, Notch hired many new developers to work with him and maintain the ever-growing project. So, with the help from his new studio and word of mouth in the indie community, the game got more and more popular. Minecraft managed to complete the beta test in 2011, and the first official full version of the game actually released on November 18th of 2011. However, Notch didn't stick with the project for much longer as he stepped down as lead developer on December 1st of that year, giving that position to Jens Bergensten, better known as Jeb. Now, this wasn't the first major change. It's just 2 months later, the entire studio announced they had been acquired by CraftBucket, a popular server platform in its entirety, resulting in many CraftBucket employees starting to work full-time on Minecraft servers in order to improve the online experience. Now, Minecraft was a very, very popular game in the PC community, and it didn't really hit the mainstream until the console ports started coming out. In May of 2012, the first console port was released on the Xbox 360 as a downloadable title, although this port was not developed by the studio. Instead, the 360 version was made by 4J Studios, which is a studio that specialized in porting games, as they had previously ported Oblivion to the PS3 and Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie to the Xbox Live Arcade. Following the Xbox 360 release of Minecraft, they were so satisfied with their work that they signed 4J Studios on to become their official console developer. And as of today, every console version you have played of Minecraft has been developed by 4J Studios. Now, the Xbox 360 version of Minecraft was a massive success, and it resulted in them wanting to port the game to other consoles as well, which, you guessed it, PlayStation 3 got it in 2013, and PlayStation 4 got it in 2014, and an enhanced Xbox One port released a day after the PS4 version. The early console versions of Minecraft were actually pretty old versions of the game and were not even close to the amount of content that the PC version had, although 4J Studios worked together to slowly update it to get it as close as possible to the PC version. So the console versions of Minecraft were such a massive success that it got the attention of Microsoft themselves, who wanted to capitalize on the Minecraft craze. A little over a week after the Xbox One release of Minecraft, it was announced that Microsoft had proposed a deal to Mojang to buy the company and the Minecraft IP for $2.5 billion. Even though Notch was no longer the head of the game, he was still owner of the IP, which is all that matters, people, leading to an insane profit once the deal was signed. Microsoft officially acquired Minecraft on November 6th of 2014 and person became an instant billionaire. As of the recording of this video, Notch's net worth is a whopping $1.4 billion. However, after the deal was signed, Notch and two other founders left the company entirely, officially ending their involvement with the game. So he did what he wanted to do, he got his money, and he ran. Funny enough, Minecraft actually had more plans for the studio after they acquired them. While they were obviously wanting to own the Minecraft IP, they also wanted to use the game as a way to spearhead their movement into virtual reality. Notch had originally been looking into getting Oculus Rift support of Minecraft, but he was turned off by the idea after Facebook bought the Oculus in 2013. According to him, Facebook creeps him out and he didn't want anything to do with him. However, after Microsoft acquired Minecraft and Notch was out of the picture, they once again started working with Oculus, and on August 15th of 2016, the PC version of the game officially got VR support. And believe it or not, there was actually a VR mod for the PC version of the game before it became an official thing. But once Oculus support update rolled out, Microsoft issued trademark complaints, forcing the developer to take down that specific mod. So, Minecraft sales have always been interesting to look at. While the game really doesn't, it didn't hit its stride until the console ports started coming out. There were big companies advertising it. That's not to say it didn't sell well. In fact, the original PC version of the game sold over 1 million copies by 2011 with no actual paid advertising. It was selling on word of mouth alone. Notch made himself approximately $33 million just off of those sales, which he used to create his company. And then, once the console support came, things got crazy. The Xbox Live version of Minecraft is one of the most profitable games ever, as the team turned a profit within the first 24 hours of the game launching, which that's not heard of, people. It sold over 1 million copies within its first 7 days on the market, and then it sold another 12 million by the end of the second year, and that's just the 360 version. The PS3 version sold another million copies in 5 weeks, and the PlayStation Vita outsold both the PS3 and the PS4 versions. It's insane. The Pocket Edition of Minecraft has even sold over 21 million copies. Across all versions of the game on all platforms, Minecraft has sold over 122 million copies, making it the second best-selling game of all time, with the number one still being Tetris. But it's close. Tetris has 130 million copies sold. Despite the insane success of his game and the legacy that he created, Notch has stated in interviews and online that he actually hates being a millionaire. Now, after selling the company, he claimed that he felt incredibly isolated and that human interaction had become impossible. He also stated on Twitter that despite his efforts to make sure everyone at the studio was happy with his deal and well taken care of, many of them hated him once the deal was signed. He also made a comment in August of 2015 that he would Musk and try to save the world, but that just exposes me to the same type of assholes that made me sell Minecraft again. So I get it to a degree, but then again, it's how you handle your situations. I mean, I don't know. You guys let me know. Could you possibly hate being a millionaire? And finally, perhaps the most dreaded and iconic aspect of Minecraft is the creeper. These little guys will come at you and destroy everything you worked on if you're not careful, but did you guys know that the creeper wasn't actually supposed to be in the game at all? When initially creating animals and the other AI creatures for the Minecraft world, a programming error causes a pig to become tall, skinny, and green. Rather than correct this and move on, the developers decided to go with it, so they slapped a face on it and programmed it to explode around structures. Now, how different would Minecraft be today if that mistake was never made, or if that mistake was never corrected? And there you have it, my friends. There's 10 interesting facts that I'm hoping you found informative about the popular game Minecraft. The whole point of the Fact Series is to dig a little deeper and give you guys some insight, and hopefully you walk away from the video saying, wow, I actually didn't know that about the topic. We can do any topics, video games, people, place, product, space, robots, doesn't matter. Whatever you guys want me to do, I can make it happen. So let me know in the comment section, check out the playlist below with all the other Facts videos, and I'll see you tomorrow for a new one.